Hello everyone, my name is Sam Spade. Welcome to another Coding Fundamentals in GML tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be talking about the with statement. The with statement is a built-in GameMaker statement. It takes an instance ID, an object ID, or the keyword all, and a code block. If you give it an instance ID, it'll run that code block just for that instance. If you give it an object ID, it'll run that code block for all instances of that object. And if you give it the keyword all, it'll run the code block for all instances. Here we have a couple examples. First, we have the keyword all. This would go through every active instance and run this code, whatever we put in here, for every single instance. Here we have object ball. Let's assume that this is an object ID. It would run whatever we put here for all instances of object ball and this is very important, every object that inherits from object ball. Down here, we have with inst. Let's assume that this is an instance ID. This would just run this code for this instance. Another great thing about the with statement is that it automatically checks whether or not an instance exists. Or maybe a better way to put it is it won't run or trigger an error if an instance does not exist. So with this example here, if this instance somehow didn't exist, we would not get an error. This code just wouldn't run. So here is a simple flowchart of the with statement. You'll notice that it is very similar to a loop because essentially, if there is more than one instance, or if you give the with statement the keyword all or an object ID, it will function exactly like a loop. It'll check to see whether or not it can find an instance, and if it can, it will run that code. Then it'll go and check for the next instance, and as long as it can find another instance, it'll run that code, and so on until there are no more instances, at which point the with loop or the with statement will finish. So as we said, the with statement iterates through all instances of an object, and it works for all children and all the children's children of an object as well. The scope inside of the with block changes to the instance that is currently running the code. So for example, here, with inst, once we're in this code block right here, the scope is no longer the instance that is calling the with statement, but the instance inside right here. The with statement also allows you to use the keyword other. It's one of only two places where the keyword other is allowed, the other being the built-in collision event. So as I mentioned, inside of the with statement, the scope changes to that instance, and it allows you to use the keyword other. Again, the with statement is one of only two times that you can use the keyword other. Other refers to the instance ID of the instance running the with statement. Now the best way to understand this is to see it in action, so let's switch over to GameMaker Studio 2 and see a couple examples. Before we run the code, I'm going to go over the objects. There's going to be one instance of this object, object with statement. Its create event just initializes a variable, an instance variable, myInst equals no one. No one is a keyword in GameMaker Studio 2. It's equal to the number -4, and I often use it if I'm going to have a variable that will refer to an instance, but might not at this point. So in the step event, we just have a couple things. If we press the keyboard key 1, we're going to loop through every active instance, and we're going to run event user 0. The great thing about custom user events is they won't fire or cause an error if they don't exist. So in fact, the only object that has an event user 0 is this one right here, object dummy version 2. You can switch over. All it does is show debug message my name. If we push 2, we're going to go through dummy parent, every instance of dummy parent, and we're going to do the show debug message my name. Now, dummy parent has two children. They're dummy object version 1 and dummy object version 2. Both of these objects have the variable my name. So when you say with dummy parent, it will go and find both of those objects or all instances of these objects and it will print the variable my name. Finally, we have if mouse check button pressed mb any, which just means any mouse button. If there is any instance attached to the variable my instance, it will destroy that instance. And if not, it will create a new instance of object white dot and assign the variable or assign its instance ID to my inst. And then with my inst will update object white dot's x and y position to mouse x and y, effectively making the white dot follow the mouse pointer. Notice that white dot itself doesn't actually have any code. All right, let's run this and see what happens. Okay, so I've run it in the debugger so we can see the instances. And over here, you can see that currently in this room, even though you can't see anything, we have three instances of dummy object version 1 and three instances of dummy object version 2 and one instance of object with statement. The first thing we can do is push 1 and we get unhelpful example 20, 25, and 33. And if we switch over here to variables, we can see that, again, unhelpful example 33, these are their names, unhelpful example 25, and unhelpful example 30. And indeed, that's what we got printed out over here. We can hit 2. So now we're looping through all instances of the dummy objects. And finally, if we click our mouse button, we'll create an instance of object white dot, which you can see down here, and it'll follow our mouse pointer around. So switching back over to the code here, one thing I want to point out is that until we clicked our mouse, myInst said no one. So we were saying with myInst, which again was saying with no one, do this, and nothing happened. We weren't getting an error or crashing, even though we are referencing a non-existent object, because the with statement won't crash if you give it a bad instance ID. It simply won't do anything with the code. Now, the last thing I want to demonstrate is the keyword other. So let's come in here and type in show debug message other.myInst. Now, again, remember that when we're inside this block right here, the scope of the code is actually object white dot, because that's what we've created an instance of and saved to this variable. Now, object white dot has x and y, these variables, because these are built in and included with all of GameMaker Studio 2 objects, but it does not have the variable myInst. If we want to reference myInst, then we have to use the keyword other, because other refers to this instance right here, object with statement. So let's run this and see what I mean. Okay, so the debug is run. Notice object white dot doesn't exist, but we click over here, we create it. Now we can see that object white dot has no variables that we've defined, but it has a bunch of built-in variables. Specifically, it has x and y right here, but it doesn't have myInst. MyInst is actually a variable of object with statement, and you'll see 100026, 100026. So myInst is the instance ID of this instance of object white dot. And in fact, if we were to come into the code over here and put a breakpoint, we would immediately stop. So now we've stopped and we can see that other equals 100024, which indeed is the instance ID of object with statement. And now myInst 100026 again is the instance ID of object white dot. So all of this is now valid because other is referring to object with statement, and object with statement has the variable myInst. So in summary, the with statement is great for looping or iterating over instances. It can be used with both objects and instance IDs. It changes the instance scope to the instance running the code inside the with block. And it allows you to use the keyword other to refer back to the object that has the with block itself. As always, the links in this slide will be below. I want to call special attention to the with block recipe cards tutorial, which is available on the official GameMaker community forum. It has lots of examples and should give you a better idea both of how the with statement works and what you can do with them. That's it. Thanks for watching.